is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. We are on our way right now to my new hunting property. I'm super stoked. This has been like a lifelong dream for me. Lifelong as in like since I've been in the woods for the first time with my dad at like the age of 5 or 6. I've just always thought I want to be in the woods all the time. I want to be able to hunt anytime I want to. I want to be able to spend time out there chasing whitetails, planting food plots, hanging stands, making bedding areas. Like, I've just been in love with the outdoors since a super young age, and I just wanted to have my own piece of ground someday that I could go out and do whatever I wanted, whenever I wanted to, with me and Reagan and our family, have a good time and enjoy a little bit of creation. And that's what this is really all about, and I'm just super, super stoked. But we actually sign the final paperwork tomorrow on the property. However, I've already put down all the down payment and all the other paperwork leading up to this. It's already a done deal, you know. I've already put the money down on it and everything, that 20%. So it really, in the morning, is just the first time that we can both meet up at the same time to sign off on the final papers that we have to both sign on, and then that's pretty much it. I mean, we've got a new piece of ground. We're gonna be filming a lot of deer hunts over there. We're gonna be doing some Lot and Proud videos over there here soon too, making a little mud toy for the river. It's just gonna be a lot of fun. So we're gonna go over there right now. I have the first gen right now, which, by the way, we're giving this truck away. 48 hours left to enter to win it. And all you do is go to lnpgear.com, links in the description, and every $1 right now is 20 entries for the last few days. And then we're gonna be putting random amounts of cash in every single order. Not just some orders get cash, every single order gets cash. So anyways, guys, if you wanna win the truck, links in the description, you're running out of time. Let's get on over to the property and have some fun.
Just got the first setup done. Cameraman setup. We've got about 18 feet of elevation, 16-ish to the platform, 18 probably to the seat. Got another cell camera setup here. And then up there, got the main stand, the bow hanger right up above it, with the cameraman stand and a bow hanger right behind that. Ready for tomorrow afternoon.
So I actually spoke to the previous landowner and I asked him what the best spot was to hunt on this property for buck activity. And he said, hunt the spot next to the river in that one location that's kind of open. And there's only one location that's kind of open, and this is it. And it's not even a very big spot. It's about 3/4 of an acre that's kind of open. The rest of it is just thick, nasty, briary, brushy. I mean, it's pretty rough. So here's the setup and here's the location. Right behind me here. It's a really killer spot. As you guys just saw, the river location here. I'm trying to keep it down a little bit because we're going to be hunting here tomorrow. I don't really have a lot of options. I just had to get in here and put my stand up if I was going to hunt. Got that set up. We're going to go set up another location right now on the far side of the property for a different wind. As much as I love to hunt this spot probably every time, that's how you mess things up. So we're going to go set up a stand on the far side of the property for a north wind. That way we have a north wind setup because this stand is going to be ideal for a west wind, which is going to be blowing straight down the river, which is going to be blowing our scent out towards the parking lot slash road out that direction where the least amount of bedding activity is. That way, coming and going from the property, we're not completely blowing the property out every single time. That's going to be the goal. Hopefully it works out. And he said that this is the tree basically that he shot 3 nice bucks out of last year. And when I say he shot 3 bucks, I'm saying him, his wife, and his, I think it was a brother or friend, close friend, they shot 3 bucks out of this spot last year within a couple week time frame. And he's like, the bucks just run this creek bed in the rut, and it is just awesome. So we're looking forward to it. Let's get on over to the next spot.
Well, we just got out of the property. I didn't go back and film the second stand setup because by the time I got back to the truck, it's 5 o'clock, and usually on the cameras, the deer are starting to go pretty good on the cameras around then, so didn't really want to hike back there just to booger it all up if we are going to try to hunt tomorrow. The spots that I put in, they're pretty invasive. I mean, they're not way back in there, like in the middle of everything. They're kind of like hunting the outskirts of the main travel corridors that I've seen on the property, so we'll see what happens. We're just going to have to adjust and adapt as the season goes on.
Well, we are back from the new property, and I wanted to go over this truck a little bit with you guys real quick. So just got it all cleaned up the other day. I drove it from here to my parents' property, actually their house, which was about 15-ish miles. And I did some back road driving, some highway speeds. I was probably going about 70. And the truck drove great. I mean, drove awesome. The only thing that I would say was a little bit annoying was that I don't have my windshield wiper blades on to keep my new glass from fogging up and stuff, and it was pretty foggy last night. But other than that,
truck drove super good, performed really well, didn't have any issues. The only thing that I will complain about is the fact that the tach doesn't work. You know, you don't have any speedometer, you don't have any mileage counting up right now. Fuel gauge doesn't work, even though I know it's full, because when I first parked it in my barn, I put a full tank in there and I haven't driven it really since, other than a couple little trips. You know, some little things that are kind of annoying that we'll probably have to get fixed here soon. No heat, no AC, just a bunch of little oddball things that need to get taken care of. But otherwise, the truck drove really good. It performed well. Super happy with it. I really do love it.
And I'm thinking for now, what I'm probably gonna do is leave the truck at the current ride height and then start working on some performance upgrades and improvements to the drivetrain before doing anything suspension related like I was planning on doing first, just because, yeah, it'll look cooler with a big set of wheels and tires and a big lift, but I want to touch up this thing under the hood and get some things going under there, because I know that truck will be so fun to drive the way it is, honestly, if it just had more power. That is going to be the end of this short, very short video for today. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I just didn't have a lot going on today, but I figured I'd grab the camera, give you guys a little update on our new property. Don't forget that if you want to enter to win this truck, the giveaway for this thing ends in less than 48 hours now. So if you want to get your entries in, we're offering 20X entries for the last few days, which we're now down to just under 2 days, and then the giveaway is going to be gone. So every $1 gets you 20 entries, and every order gets random amounts of cash.
Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Also, another question: should we put a light bar in the bumper of the third gen? I feel like it would kind of make that ugly gap look a little bit better. I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.